Several businesses in Kampala have been disrupted following a heavy downpour that lasted hours. The heavy rains left parts of Kampala no-go areas. Jinja Road, Mokwano Road and Chinawataka Roads were all flooded. Around many streets in Kampala, floods paralyzed the movement of both pedestrians and motorcyclists as traders with shops dealing in agricultural products at Container Village and others downtown were forced to close after water entered their shops. Some traders largely attributed the floods to blocked drainage systems along the roads. They asked Kampala Capital City Authority to open up the blocked drainage systems to allow easy water flow because it breaks into waterborne diseases. Relatedly, Jinja City was devastated by a heavy downpour that occurred today morning, paralyzing businesses. The rains not only destroyed property, but left many roads impassable. The dwellers are seeking government intervention on fixing the roads that are in a sorry state. Walukuba Masese Road is one of the busiest roads in the city as it leads to the industrial hub of the city. Due to the deplorable state, the road was cut off by floods, putting transport at a standstill.
Is the most busiest road around here, especially from the tip top, from Dunlop up to Masese. It has factories which give us, they pay the tax to the government. So we call upon the government to help us and work upon the road. So as you have seen, what has happened in front there, most of people's cars were taken away by the water. So we call upon the government to work upon this road.
Many pedestrians and people in vehicles were stranded as they could not cross to either side.
Not sturdy. And this is BMW. Here I cannot get the mechanic. Because when I was passing, nobody was here. That truck was going, I was behind him. That also stuck there. Water level is up to this point, my brother. Up to thigh. It came up to this point, water. Those are the people that pushed me back, you asked them.
Cars submerged as others were carried away by the running water. Across the city, a series of houses submerged, some structures destroyed, and some business people lost their merchandise as water flooded their businesses. Residents and investors using the road asked the city authorities to intervene as it has resulted in a death trap whenever it rains. Some, however, blamed the authorities for allowing the investors to set up factories in wetlands blocking the waterway.
In the last 2 years, so we are in fact we are disappointed by the government, mainly the Ministry of Works, because this is a very vital road. It has 17 factories employing people, and these factories, they pay a lot of tax. Can you imagine that MMI is on this road? We have Bidico, we have Nylas, we have Kesola Group of Companies, we have Filiala, East African Steel Corporation. They are all those are factories that they are paying a lot of tax to this government, but look at the state of the road. They cannot even access their factories. Look at their cars. Look at their cars, the way the road is. In fact, we are not happy as residents. And two, these factories were opened by the government, by the president of Uganda. They are constructed in swamp.
As a city of Jinja, we acknowledge the challenge of the road infrastructure. We are aware that the state in which the roads in this city are, they're in a sorrow state. The roads are in a deplorable state. But we've managed to work on some of them. And thanks be to the USAID program that has really supported us to ensure that we improve on the road infrastructure in the city. But we still have a lot to do, because if you look at the total kilometers that we have in the city, it's almost to the tune of about 600 kilometers. And out of the 600 kilometers, if you look at the roads which are tarmacked in the entire city, it does not add up even to 15%.
Report compiled by Disan Mutyaba and Ivan Lubega for the news.